Who am I? I am TRO. I am Truth, Realness, and Options. I am Jeff Trotter, executive producer and editor for TRO. I wish everyone a safe and a prosperous New Year and holiday. And you already know I had to be part of this special occasion in some form or fashion. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you sit back, relax, and enjoy the season finale of TRO, Truth, Realness, and Options.
Truth, Realness, and Options, our last podcast for the year. I'm glad to have a wonderful friend here and a wonderful artist here that we're playing on today. And this is our last show. I hope that this year was a very informative year from Truth, Realness, and Options. And if you have any suggestions, please let us know on Facebook. We'd be more than happy to hear you out and address those issues on Truth, Realness, and Options. But today, we got my best friend, one of my friends I ain't seen in a while, Mr. Jeremy Unmask Smith. He's in the building, Mr. B-Mac himself. What's up, Doc?
What's happening, man?
Chillin', man. Clean as a clap, Doc.
Yes, sir. Got my little holiday outfit on.
Yes, yeah,
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, so we got him here, man, to end us out, man. Say the best for last, huh?
Yeah.
Say the best for last, and it's good to see you out, man. Thanks to our audience who just came in, and if you don't know who he is, I'm gonna let him introduce himself. But before you do that, I'll just let you know I've been knowing him, what, for 5 years now?
5 years.
We started at the slave ship called TP.
Right.
Yeah, and
they know what the initials are.
Yeah, they know what them is. So, and ever since then, me and him been knowing each other, been doing music, he's been doing shows and been prospering, and we both grew together. And so I wanted him to come out to the show, but just let us know, man, who you are for those who don't know you on a personal level like me.
Yeah, well, I'm comedian Jeremy Unmask Smith. I am a resident of Shreveport, Louisiana. You probably seen me do movie 70s. I've been at your local church, baby showers or something. You probably seen me in traffic catching a sports train or something. But I'm up and coming comedian, man, and like I can say that this year has been a very prosperous year. Been doing a lot of traveling, doing a lot of shows, you know.
What's up?
Yeah, so, I mean, I'm happy to be here, man. You know, all these interviews, they count.
Yes, you know, sir.
About time y'all let me get on the show. I'm sitting here watching from afar, but I'm so close.
You know, yes, sir, Doc. Well, I'm glad you're here. Everybody, you know, he's a great comedian. Been doing shows at, where you been at, Doc? I know you been at the...
I did Club Haze.
Yeah, Haze.
I had a good travel time here in Shreveport. I've done the Vicki Robinson Theater.
Okay.
Did her show.
Right.
I did some stuff. I did the Laugh House where Kevin Hart was in Philadelphia.
Right.
I did Caroline's in New York. I'd have been in Chicago. Down South Louisiana, Dillard University called me, you know, to come down there in New Orleans and do my thing. So I'd have been somewhere everywhere, small towns and different states and stuff like that. Dallas, I just came back from Dallas doing a grown and sexy show, which was very good, you know what I'm saying? But had some fun.
Had fun with it.
Yeah.
That's what it's about, man. So tell us how and when did you get started with your comedian career?
Man, 2008. I mean, I've always been funny, but I didn't dabble in music as a young kid, but 2008 really made my career. I was on the set of Soul Man with Bernie Mac,
right?
And I met him through my mother-in-law who was coming beside the stage, and I was like, that's what I want to do. But I always did the impression because I'd seen every movie he was in.
Right.
But that day I knew I wanted to get into comedy and stop doing music. So a little bit after he passed away, like the weekend after, I seen the open mic sign, and I went to the open mic and started doing my comedy, and it started from there.
That's what's up.
That's what's up.
So, you fell in love with it?
Yeah.
Fell in love with it. that that's what it's about, man. Some comedians, I see that get into it for the money, but ever since I've known you, you've been doing it, you know, for the joy and for the love, the passion of the craft, making people laugh.
Right.
Making people laugh.
It's an antidepressant, man. You know?
Yes, sir.
No. I love it. I know I'm funny. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Comedy has taken me to a place where another person couldn't get me through. You know what I'm saying? Like, well, most people, they give up.
Right.
They get down and they mope around. I just find something to laugh about. Every day that I am above ground, I can smile about something. And me doing comedy, I've seen the expressions and the release of people's pressure from life. The effect is great. So every morning I'm able to make somebody laugh, every day I'm able to make somebody laugh, it's a blessing.
It's a blessing,
yeah.
That's right. You never know what people are going through.
Right.
Right. You never know what type of life issues they're going through. You might stop somebody from killing themselves.
Right.
By joking with them, and, you know, expressing, you know, how you feel about a certain situation in comedy.
Right.
So that's a unique way to reach our brothers and sisters, man.
Right.
I'm grateful that you're doing it, man.
Right.
Keep up with it. Right now, guys, we're going to get ready to take a brief break.
All right.
And then when we come back, we got a treat for you. We're going to give him, what, a couple of minutes to do his thing. I know he y'all going to laugh, so I want y'all to stay tuned. I see a couple of people coming on live. Welcome to Truth, Realness, and Options.
Better see this suit. Better see this candy cane tie. See the trend shirt. See this.
Yes, sir. So we want to say happy holidays to you from Truth, Realness, and Options. Our executive producer, Brother Jeff Trotter, Jeff Trotter, and yours truly, QT, the executive host. And thank you again, Jeremy, for coming out. We're going to come back and stay tuned. And actually, we're going to have a musical rendition of Mary Did You Know. You heard CeeLo Green sing. Can't nobody sing it better than him, but we have Madison Prelow coming to play it on violin. She's a young, aspiring artist, man. She's a great student, and she go to church.
Yeah.
So that's a benefit, she go to church. And so stay tuned, guys, to Truth, Realness, and Options. We'll be right back with our musical rendition, and then yours truly, Jeremy L. Mads.
I mean, 2 years ago, Red River flooded. 2 years prior to that, Red River flooded. So if we, this is the depth of Red River, right? Now, each year, we have so much going through the river. And we'll say this is the amount of water that flows through the river. That's how much flows through. Well, here's the problem that's going on right now. There's walking dams that are all through the river. Yeah. So the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers comes in and said they're all failed in our area. Well, what happens if you have a failing locking dam? It is supposed to allow all the silt to flow through. What we're doing is every year 1.6 million cubic yards of silt is collected right to the north side of our city. Water's going to go somewhere. That's where it's going to go. It's going to come right back.
One thing I want to plead to them is please stop changing the standards.
Right.
That is really, you know, I understand we want higher standards and we want our teachers, our students kind of measured to gauge where they are. So I'm going to say throw out testing. But I think the standard needs to remain the same. As you and I briefly spoke about, it was no child left behind.
Right.
Then they had Common Core. Standards are changing so rapidly, almost from year to year, it's hard for schools, teachers, administrations to show that they are making progress.
When people ask me why I don't rap about, well, a lot of rappers rap about because, you know what I'm saying, it's like spitting on the grave with those people that you, those family members you know that I can't make a song about killing my own people or selling drugs to my own people. Because it's spitting on the grave on my cousins that died behind gang violence and street violence. And, you know, it's like spitting on their grave. There's nothing to glorify.
Right. Hey, all I can say is, man, research everything that's just been spoken of. Look right. Do a lot of research. Don't believe what these folks telling you. Learn, learn, learn. Time is getting short. And if you ain't gave your soul to Christ, then you better do that, man, because we in these times, bro.
We just don't know what people are going through that breaks them do the things they do, which is not an excuse, but it's just an unfortunate situation. So if we in the minority community, African-American community, whatever we want to look at it, if we could first wake up to realize that there is a problem in our community, then the next step would be to, now that we have the problem, what's the solution? So then we can act and try to see what's wrong with our brothers and sisters and be more compassionate to their situations.
Guys, welcome back to Truth, Realness, and Option. This is your host, QT, and we back in the camp. And right now, we're about to have a Christmas rendition of Mary, Don't You Know It, CeeLo style with his own violin. And this is Sister Madison Prelow, a great, great, phenomenal team. I've been going for a couple of years now. She's very talented on the violin. So we're going to turn the camera over to her, and she's going to do her thing, Mary, Don't You Know It. Take your time out for us, and we thank you for coming out, Madison, and do that for us. We thank you, and that's part of our Christmas, part of our show. She's gonna come back and give us another one shortly after this break. Again, it's Truth, Realness, and Options. Your host, QT. Stay tuned. Again, welcome back to Truth, Realness, and Options. It's been a pleasure to host this today. We got a special young lady with us. Her name is Madison Prelow. She's playing her violin today, giving a Christmas tribute. So we're gonna let her do the Christmas canon this time for her next song.
Thank you.
put her playing to the next orchestra somewhere. You know, they ain't gonna be just Mexicans, Chinese people like you see on TV. We're gonna have us a young African American that's playing. We just thank you, Madison, for coming out and doing that for us, our Christmas rendition. And so next, on Truth, Rhythms, and Options, we're about to have Mr. Jeremy Unmask. We'll come back and tap the place up. So stay in the place, stay listening, stay tuned, stay Black America, and we're gonna come back in just a second, okay? Again, this is Truth, Rhythms, and Options, your host, QT.
I love the Lord. He heard my cry, and I cried this morning. I'm gonna say
what most people don't wanna say. If your child can't say, do not put your child at the front of the choir. You know you had that one person to back you like, you know your child can't say, hey. And then you want to fight, but you know.
All right, we back on. It's Truth, Realness, and Options. Your host, QT. On behalf of the executive producer, TRO, Jeff Trotter. This is Truth, Realness, and Options, where we speak the truth, we keep it real, and we give our Black American citizens options to live a better life in America and succeed. So we're gonna move right along. We got Jeremy Unmask. We finna turn him off the leash. I hope America is ready. One boy about to come over the hill with the Jeremy Unmask effect. Right here live on Truth, Realness, and Options. Man, this on you, Doc.
Keep it
real for me.
You put the camera on me real quick. You see this suit? It's Christmas time. I'm not a pimp or sugar daddy or your granddad or deacon at the church. I'm coming to set you straight. You heard what this says. You see the picture? Now let's get something straight. It's the holidays times. Don't go out spending all your money on these kids that can't read unless there's a leapfrog. Get them a Bible, dial a tree. Get them something to write with. You know your baby caca. Go get the baby check and some glasses. I'm so sick of us as African Americans. And you can't tell me that I've been Black a long time. It's me, Wesley Snipes, Bernie Mac. God bless the dead. We've been Black a long time. Let me tell you something. If you stay in the projects this Christmas, you should be looking for upgrade. I don't want to see no rims, because you ain't going to do nothing but pun that baby game come the mid of income tax season. Stop going out buying $1 million hair and your baby got a $4 dress.
Yes, sir.
Stop showing up at these churches only on holidays and when somebody died. And for you people out there, stop going to funerals line when you see your cousin in the casket. They would call it crying. When you cry and you lie, I'm gonna be there for you. Call me. We need to stop this. After the repast, you gone. Pastors, yeah, I'm gonna say what you're scared to say. If you won't speak into my life, put a peppermint in your mouth. I'm sick and tired of God's word coming back void because I can't receive it. Get some try this. Mentos, the fresh maker. Let me tell you, some trying to lay hands on me. One dude thought he had me. No, I had high blood pressure. I passed out. It wasn't the spirit. I was out. I was almost in a coma. You had to call the people, the ambulance people.
That's something.
We're going to tell the truth, because the truth is going to set you free. If you know you're still starting, stop going there trying to be a missionary. That ain't your season. If your baby still, stop trying to let them take up our offering. If your baby can't sing, stop trying to put that child in front of the church. We streaming live. Baby got low self-esteem because you right here putting your baby up there just because you on the usher boat. If your usher boat gloves are dirty, stop trying to touch people. If you're a youth pastor, stop trying to be the pastor of the church.
Yes, sir.
You can't even read. They give you one thing to do on youth Sunday, you think you're going to start a church. I'm going to tell it like this. It's holiday time, and I'm ending with this. That's my second closing. That's how the pastor gets you.
Yes, sir.
It is offering time. When you go to somebody's house, respect. Stop going through people's stuff. You know the bathroom ain't next to the master bedroom. You seen when your sister got spoken, the Lord spoke into her life, and she was going to get half a million. No, her husband got hit by a truck. That's how they got it. Called the Tracy Morgan effect. Little Tracy Morgan. What I'm saying? Stop going to people's house. You know, see, they only have in the black community. They won't go through every room in the house to beat nothing. You knew the bathroom was over there with the light on. All the rooms had a lock on the door. You try to screw it back in. Because you know it. If you can't cook, leave your dish at home. We're going to feed you. I'm so sick of your mashed potatoes. Smelling like baby burp. I don't want to taste that. If your macaroni is harder than dudes in prison, you need to leave it at the house. I'm tired. You ain't gonna get no man like that since you're lying. Yes, sir. If your lace front still got that screen in, kill yourself. It's 2018, and I'm gonna say this and I'm gonna close. If I catch any one of y'all that go to watch night saying the same thing that you left at the altar next year, I'm kicking you in the chest. This has been your comedy updates. I'm comedian Jeremiah Madden. Merry Christmas. Tell them about to sit down.
Preacher.
I'm gonna tell the truth.
Yes, sir. That's the truth, the realness.
Yeah.
And he gave you some options. Go to that altar with that foolishness in 2019.
You want me to tell you the truth?
Yes, sir.
Why my picture right there look better than I look in person? Would y'all Photoshop me or something?
We gotta talk to the executive producer.
Yeah, right.
He'd be a clean cut. This is the 2019 updated version.
Yeah, I'm gonna lose weight. If I'm a girl who can't cook, you always be in shape. It's a lot of them.
It's a lot of them.
Yeah.
These millennials. Not millennials, the millennials.
Right.
So we, man, appreciate that, man.
Hey, you know, I'm gonna tell you, know.
True realism and options from Jeremiah Madden.
Yeah.
And so we gonna shift, but we gonna keep real.
Yeah,
we done had a crazy, crazy year in Shreveport. A lot of killings, a lot of murders, people burning up people in Shreveport, you know. And now we got a new mayor.
Right.
And I wanna ask you, man, how you feel about that? Like, he young, you know, everybody was, you know, tripping off the fact that he's a young person and he may not have the caliber to serve in the capacity as what he's doing right now as our mayor. And so what you think about that, man?
First of all, age ain't nothing but a number.
That's right.
We're gonna keep it real. He young, so he know what's happening in the streets. He came up in what was happening in the streets. The thing about it is, we get so focused on age and how things used to be ran. That's what's wrong with America. That's what's wrong with the city now.
That's right.
We do have some people that are profound and proficient to do the same job you were doing. That's why he might have been doing exactly what he was supposed to do to get where he is today. You know, the Bible says train up a child in the way it goes. So how you know that he wasn't being trained up for this moment?
Right.
You know, we so hooked on how they used to do it when mom and them was doing it. But mom and them left their lives. The baby boomers, they lived their lives to the fullest. It's our generation we gotta protect. If the brother got a passion to make change for this city, then I trust that he gonna do what he, you know, supposed to do, because guess what, we holding him accountable.
Right.
As long as he get in there and do exactly what he say he gonna do, you know, or try to, at least show some effort, show his face when it's needed, when it's time, then guess what? He got my vote. You know, I loved our former mayor. She did a great job while she was in office. She did what she was supposed to do. She made a few changes, necessary changes. But God seen fit for it was time for somebody else to step in and continue the work she did and maybe push something, you know, that she couldn't get pushed, you know. So, I mean, if the brother gonna do what he say he gonna do or try or put his best foot forward, hey, my brother, hey, best of luck to you. You got my blessing. We need to start praying for the people that we put in office. That's the problem. We wanna shoot them down and do things, you know, to distort their name or try to make them not qualified. You don't see that way in the other race. They might not even like each other.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? But you think the Republicans, you think they gonna care about the Democratic Party when they too busy winning? You know what I'm saying? So long as we winning, guess what? Let's just let the brother do what he gotta do. You know, you don't see other races wanna die on top. They might not even like each other, but just so somebody else can't ever get what? They gonna stick together.
Stick together.
So long as we stick together as the adults now, guess what? Playtime over. Mom and them did what they supposed to do. They getting their social security. You make sure you put the right people in office so we can continue to get ours when we get the age.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
That's how I see
some
it.
Some morals and values and to right. the structure. Now I see that he, according to the Shreveport Times, that he already got his cabinet, his right. transitioning team, which looked awesome. Right. He got a Harvard professor from Harvard Law School. He has, let's see. What's it? Ray Belton, president of Southern University System. So he's attacking right. education.
Right.
Retired Army Lieutenant Robert Towson, who had retired and he's come to Shreveport to help him out.
Oh, yeah.
Was in the United States Military Academy in New York. So we got some structure as far as policing, I see.
Right.
We got some help with that. And then he has Bob Elder, retired Air Force Lieutenant. Gerald Frew, Louis D. Brandes. What's else? Rachel Lawler. Which is a owner of Rachel and Company Realty in Shreveport. So he got housing marketing, I see, you know, development, housing development coming. Elliot Rogers, Senior Vice President of Logistics at Ulta Beauty. Dr. Navdi Samra, Professor and Program Director in the Department of General Surgery at LSU Health System, Shreveport. Tangela Sylvie, Shantae Wells, which is my cousin. Attorney Shantae Wells, he got him on his office. And let's see, Cheryl White and Joshua Williams, Assistant Cattle Parish District Attorney for cattle. So it looked like he got a good team that's attacking all sectors.
Yeah, so the pressure really ain't on him, but it is. What I'm saying is, your team got to help you win.
Right.
That's and it. We know that the biggest thing about Shreveport is judicial system, right. You know what I'm saying? So if he can get that in education, man, the rest of it will fall in place. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Along with the judicial system, you got the law enforcement, of course, and stuff like that. But education, if we can educate people to understand what he's trying to push for the city, mm-hmm. then the better I will be. We got too many ignorant people. They don't want to know. You know, they see you in the suit. They vote for you. They expect you to be God. I can't do everything that he do with the snap of a finger. I ain't Thanos.
Right.
But I'm just saying, you know, right. people want you to be a superhero
right.
at the same time represent them. But if you get educated, and this is to the people, if you get educated and know the laws and sitting in some of these council meetings and stuff that he set for and pushed, then guess what? You'll understand when it's time for him to do it. We shouldn't have to overcome and walk the street after something happened. Let's attack it before it even
get to that point.
Right.
Right, right. And you know, political science, political science wise, they were saying that in the political science survey that the average person, not just black, but black, white, Hispanic, don't matter, they really don't know how to pass the U.S. citizen test if they had to get it. So they don't understand, you know, the significance of going to a public service meeting or right. going to a council meeting or going to sit into a school board meeting. Black people, we need to go. Especially us, we need to be front and center at these forums that they have in our communities. That's the only way we'll be able to know what's going on.
Right.
You know, you look at Channel 12 and say, oh, somebody got shot down the street from me, but where were you at the city council meeting?
Right.
Where were you at to give your opinion on what was going on, how the police should be policing your area? You know, we gotta get up off our butts, get off this Facebook and this Instagram.
Right.
You know, I'm not talking about the ones who tuning in, keep tuning in, yeah. but, you know, we need to be real with ourselves. What are we doing as citizens, as an African-American community, and our communities as being a productive citizen? Right. Sitting down, being nosy and complaining, looking out our front window,
right.
you know, ducking the dodging bullets, that's not getting us nowhere. We need to take front and center approaches towards the violence that's in our city. You know, yeah, we got a new mayor. Yeah, he was a military person from West Point, and he had a military political background, but he can't do it by himself. Like I said, we gonna have to, as citizens, get off our butt and actually attend those meetings, attend those mayoral meetings, those mayoral forums, and do our thing as a black community, man. When we stick together, man, just fathom what we can, you know, conquer. The things that we can do in our city. And I really believe if we get back to that, if we really get back to that, if we can have that Martin Luther King effect on our families and on our friends and neighbors again, I think we'll prosper.
Yeah.
We'll get somewhere. Man, Speaking of that, politics and political stuff, man, what you think about Donald Trump and this government shutdown, supposed to shut down tonight if they don't, Senate don't close out tonight, correct? What you think about the tantrums that the House and Senate is saying that he's throwing and the unrest in politics right now?
I mean, my take on it is, he's spoiled, man. And see, the thing is, why should I take responsibility for my actions if they're gonna let me get away with it?
That's right.
Okay, you ain't hold now. We finna get off Republicans and Democratic of the dynamics of it. He's the only president in history that get to do this. You know what I'm saying? Other Republicans were better than him. That's just my personal opinion. Now, we might not like it the way that they were handling it, but it was a lot better than this. We understood what we were fighting. This is just, he wake up, eat some Cheetos, turn the same color to Cheetos, and then he go out and he just cause hell to anybody that stands in his way.
Yeah.
But he's smart enough to know what he can get away with. If they don't say nothing to me, and I got 90% of the House,
right.
You damn right I'm gonna say and do what I wanna do. I'm gonna do this. See, Trump reminds you of one of them kids that used to get bullied. Mm-hmm. He knew his hairline receiving when you were getting young, and you know. And he said, one day, when I get some money, I help him get in power.
Yes, sir.
Some people gonna pay, so he's making other people pay if he don't like it.
Right.
He's like a bully that was bullied when he was little. You know what I'm saying? Like I say, Bush and them, you know, they had their ways of thinking when they was in the White House, Eisenhower and all these people that was there before him in the Republican Party, but I've never seen one more unorganized than this one.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? But as long as we let him do it, what happened to we are the people? We just, you know, I had to learn that in school and I ain't seen it yet. We the people know how to come together and fight and shoot each other, but we the people don't know how to stand against injustice of all people.
All people.
You know?
And I agree with you, even though the Constitution wasn't centered around the black people.
But, yeah.
But we the people. You know, the Black Panthers was the greatest example of that. You know what I'm saying? We took our own resources and develop a system that worked for us.
And in Oklahoma too.
And scared people, yeah.
Black Wall Street.
Black Wall Street. And then you had the African Society in Philadelphia that, God rest their soul, that was bombed by the people back in the 80s, man. You know, we was able to take our own resources and they are scared of us doing that.
Right.
But to see that happen mean that we can do it now.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And we should do that, man. Look at the House. It's divided, the Senate is divided, and the people are just dropping out like flies from the administration, which is scary.
I mean, you know it's bad when Republicans get tired of a Republican.
Yeah.
And they all right, you know what I'm saying? You got them like, you know what, now, we don't even really just like this dude like that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But what are you going to do? You know what I'm saying? You know it's bad when you turn on your own, start eating your own young, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
But it comes from letting get away with it. Why must the government continue to shut down?
Right.
Now, something is wrong with that. Of all people, I don't care if you don't like a certain group of people, you are still going to be affected if the government shuts down.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So that means that you need to look at the head, because if the head died, and the head ain't gonna straighten this, the body is gonna slow down and eventually die. The organs gonna stop pumping. So if our head is screwed on right, then guess what? The body is gonna die, you know?
And it's saying that I know that it's in the judicial power, the Supreme Court and Congress can impeach him. Judicial system, most so on the unlawful part. And we know that, everybody know, this is nothing new. Everybody know that they done called him in so many cases.
Right.
And I think it's just a time and matter of impeachment. So my thing for America is where we going next? Yeah. After impeachment, then what?
And that's why they ain't did nothing yet. You just hit the hammer, the nail on the head with the hammer. You know, the thing is, if we get rid of him, who can we put in there that we trust? So therefore, you rather deal with a bull until you find the proper person to put there. So it's like we the land of the lost. We just threw somebody in there. That seemed to be straight, but then it's just like being with the retarded girl and you don't know she's slow. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
She looked good. She looked like a stallion. But when she opened her mouth, you find out that she should have been in an education class with a special ed chick. Yeah. So now you got the retarded fine girl running through the thing. And ain't nobody saying that because she fine. And ain't nothing about that dude look good, you know. But I'm just saying, the way that we handle him is just like a girl with a body with no mindset.
Right. And it's killing the American society.
It's killing everybody. What the little handicapped dude, what, he was handicapped during Pearl Harbor. I mean, the president.
The president.
Even he stood up for what he believed in. He ain't had no legs.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Right there,
yeah, but I'm just saying, like, when you come to that right there, he's acting like that because we allow him to. I don't care if you're Republican. I don't care if you're Democrat, liberal, independent. When something don't look right that can affect your family member that is voting something else, you got to start looking at your family tree and see how it's affecting them down the line. Everybody ain't sitting in Congress in your family. Everybody ain't living on no compound.
Right.
You know, it's just people in your family struggling too. So we the people need to get together and stop letting spoiled brats get in the office and run this country and start getting educated people in there that really is about the people, but have their own independent views right. about life and how they want to see it go, but be somewhat fair. Believe what you believe.
Right.
Stop using God's name in vain.
That's right.
You God blessing America, but you doing everything that's against Him right. to the American people and to God's people. You know, those that believe Him. And then, not to prolong or be long-winded like a pastor, but...
No, you good, Doc. You good.
We are getting some form of punishment from God because He said, I told y'all, if you keep on with this behavior, I'm going to let you see what your disobedience is going to get you. And boom, here we are. Now, when we had peace, we didn't want peace. Now, we're screaming for peace and can't get peace.
Yeah.
And then it's our generation too that is really being targeted because we don't want to do nothing responsible. We want to jump around and act a fool, fight, be on social media.
Tap each other down.
Exactly. And don't want to be responsible for our actions as citizens. And that's what it all comes down to. Is the next generation going to step up to the plate and say enough is enough, or are we going to continue the cycle? You know?
And then listening to this music that we got out.
I mean, you can't even understand it, so how is that going to affect you? You don't listen to the beat?
That's it. And they listen to two words, but they actually live by those words. And right. That's a disturbing factor in our millennial societies that they take two or three words and they actually live by it and feel like that's a way of life. And then the government is in such turmoil, so you have these new standards and ways of thinking mixed in with that. Man, we hit it to a road of destruction. I know the Bible said we're living in our last days, and that may be a part of it, but America, when we gonna wake up, Black America especially, when we gonna wake up, man? We the only race that is at each other's heads, man.
For no reason. And then, like you said, with the music effect, let me tell you something, parents. Stop your cheering from being dumb. For 2 cents a day, we can whip these children back into shape. Take all iPads, iPhones. You seen the baby over there playing the violin. She got a good mom and them. When you say mom and them, that means that's the village raising this child. Yeah, mama got a strong belt. You can tell, I feel it in my spirit. Because these children are getting out of hand.
Yes, sir.
You got women on here don't know song sound. I don't know how we shifted. My spirit's telling me this.
Yeah.
Speak. Look. Back in the day, the music was kick off your shoes and relax your feet.
Party on
down. Yeah. Aaron Hall, let's chill, let's settle down. That's what I want to do.
Right.
Even Luther, Big Luther though.
Big Luther.
Excuse me, miss, what's your name? Can I take you out tonight?
Yeah, yeah.
Now you want to be for the weekend, I got to go to church Sunday, you got to go. I don't even, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to call these other dudes, you know what, I'm going to bust your heads and wipe me because why you calling Brian? And
right.
Brian and all the people, they know what they're doing in your phone.
There you go.
You know what I'm saying?
That's the type of society that we live in. They don't know how to be women. Yeah. They don't know how to be men no more. They don't know how to raise a family.
And then we would say this. We ain't even got to talk about all the other men that are singing. We got Jacquees. Boy, if you don't sit down, he sweats to the punch them and say, you might be young, but you ready to catch these hands. That boy there is the king of bad karaoke. He is not the king of R&B. Exactly. It's the music.
It's the music.
You had Gerald LaVert. You know what I'm saying?
Preach that.
You had SWB rain down on me. You even had the song Divine. You had Shantae, she had a man at home. Now you want to be the side piece.
Yeah.
You know, I don't want no side pieces. Some side pieces can't cook.
You're right. And what happened to Nas? People, rappers like that.
Right.
You can understand what they say. And they, if I rule the world, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Stuff like that. We ain't got that no more. It's all about shooting, trapping, and killing. That's
killing. That's
and everybody just put it into a different beat. They say the same thing. They saying it in a retarded way.
Right.
And it's getting retarded every day.
And then you like bonkers and humming. Like, I mean, you got rappers out here that groups now. It's dip. We don't know what that means, but we hearing, hey.
Right.
That's the reason why Fat Park is closed. There's so many dumb people to mess up their good school.
My alumni. I'm alumni.
I know. I used to love dropping my sister out there looking at her friends.
Yes, sir.
Now it's closed for high school purposes, and now the middle school
is running rampant.
Right.
Running rampant.
You know what I'm saying? But that's just the society we live in. Yeah. This thing said tell the truth. You heard what you see the name. We tell the truth from music, politics, religion. If you don't like it, get your life together.
Get right.
You know.
Get your life.com.
Right, because if we living in the last days, I'd be doggone if I let you take the last of the last. And tax season about to come up too.
Yeah,
I'm going to say this, and I'm going to let you have back. Parents, if we could just put our children in the closet till tax time, what a world this would be. You dying, boy, you got some stuff on layaway. You want to go out here and get shot? Then you got on skinny jeans with some J's. I just bought them J's with my check. And you get shot, but you can't even get a scholarship.
Can't read.
You can't go to DeBry. You know what I'm saying? You can't go to Virginia College in the mall. All the little girls doing hair in the kitchen. I done went to Walmart barber doll sitting on the shelf, baby hair ain't even braiding. You don't even have a girl that want to braid hair. They want to twerk, but you can't do your homework. Oh, bless you. Let me tell you something. I'm sorry, y'all. I have came
pretty
sure, but this is the season finale. We're going to say this. We seen the baby play the violin without a head doing the swivel. That lady's gonna go somewhere when she get big.
Something
up? And she cute. And she look like somebody care about her. She didn't come up here with a two little shirt on. And she knew how to play the instruments. Y'all don't even know how to work an iPhone, but you want one. You wanna Snapchat it up, but you don't wanna do work. I tell you to wash the dish, you tell me what you ain't gonna do. We used to be in a coma.
That's right.
America need a whooping.
America.
America is just like a dyslexic child with nobody to take care of. I'm sorry, America, but I'm gonna say this today. I'm sorry, Doc, I felt that.
You know, it's in your
spirit. All the preachers be saying that, they're like, you know what I feel is.
It's in my heart.
For 3 cents a minute, you can help us stop these dudes from driving with rims on their car in this prime time. For 3 cents a day, we can stop people from lying about what they're going to do with their taxes.
Yes, sir.
For 4 cents a day, we're going to stop all bitter baby mamas from putting good dudes on child support. For 4 cents a day, we're going to grab the skinny jean fathers and make them real dads by putting them in some jabobos.
Yes, sir.
I'm done. I'm done. That boy good.
Must be crazy. Now he's speaking truth, realness, and options.
Right.
We're going to give it to you in various forms. You got it in comedy today.
Yeah.
You got it from a politician. You got it from a great songstress and a Renata Soul. Big ups to you, big sis, wherever you at. Shalom to you. And you get it from different various ways. Any way the wind blow cool over here in truth, realness, and options, but just make sure you get it. Man, we always say thank you to all our support, to the people coming out, to all the viewers, the people who I just seen come up on the stream. I want to thank y'all. Next year, we'll be doing a lot of new things, bro. We're already going to invite you to come back out next year. We can do this thing. Keep us updated and posted. We'll post it on the website. Okay. And y'all got to support this band, man. Yeah. Jeremy Unmask, ain't nothing like him.
You can hit me up on Facebook at Jeremy Unmask Smith. You can hit me up on Instagram at comedian Jeremy _Unmask. And you can hit me up on Twitter, Unmask50. You can hit me up on hit my YouTube channel at Unmask50. You can catch me on Craigslist at Jeremy Unmask. I'm on everything, Pinterest. I'm on Backpage, but they cut that off. So you can follow me. Just Google my name, Jeremy Unmask Smith. Nothing realer than that. Bernie Mac is back.
And so this, we're gonna wrap this up next season. In January, we starting with Alex T. Bray on our next special. He's be our special guest. And history gonna be made. We're gonna have two shows in one, TRO and Disciples Voice of Hope with Alex T. Bray. And he'll be coming in and talking about his new book for 2019. We got a book coming out. So we're gonna support him. We're gonna always support each other around him. Again, we got Jeremy Unmask in the building. To our executive producer, to our studio audience, to everybody who came out, to Madison who played the violin in the Christmas renditions. We thank everybody for watching. This is Truth, Realness, and Options. Your host, QT. See y'all next year, 2019. Shalom.